Hello guys, welcome to my first lecture on the subject mathematics. This is the first class on matrix and determinant. This subject is not only important for the higher secondary based students, it is equally important for the engineering students and the entrance candidates like joint entrance, lateral exam and GATE. Here in this lecture, I am trying to explain the topics in most simple way. So let's come to the main topic. First of all, need to understand what is the matrix. Okay, take a very simple example. Suppose there are three movie halls in your area and they are respectively hall 1, hall 2 and hall 3. Moreover, there are four movies going on this season and they are movie P, movie Q, movie R and movie S. The schedule for all the halls for these four movies are like this. But in this case, one person has to make a lot of effort to understand the schedule to match his free time. But if it is arranged orderly, such a chart or array can be found, like this. In this case, one can get a better idea about this schedule. Now looking at one of the row in the chart. It is referring to the schedules for a same movie in different halls. In other case, one column is point out the schedule for four movies for a single hall. So, the quadral array, which occur by one or more rows and columns, is called a matrix. Any matrix is generally two types. If the row and column numbers are equal, it is called a square matrix. And if the row and column numbers are not equal, it is called a rectangular matrix. Then, based on this row and column layout, comes a term, order of the matrix. What is it? In simply, determine of row and column arrangement in a mathematical way in the matrix is called the order of a matrix. It is also called size of a matrix. To determine it has a format which says order of the matrix equals to m cross n, where m is number of rows and n is number of columns. The above mentioned matrix have 4 rows and 3 columns. So m cross n equals to 4 cross 3, which is the order of this matrix. The order of the matrix is written on right side in the suffix like this. Now two examples are taken. Now can you say how many order and types of these matrices? The first matrix have 3 rows and 3 columns. So m cross n is 3 cross 3 and it is a square matrix. The second matrix have 2 rows and 3 columns. So m cross n is 2 cross 3 and it is a rectangular matrix. Now, you are given 15 seconds time to solve the type and order of the four matrices below. Three different systems of enclosing the numbers constituting a matrix are in common use, namely these three types of brackets. So, any kind of writing is mean a matrix from these three types. Generally, an m cross n ordered matrix logically written as these all are called the elements of the matrix. In another word, matrix is filled by the elements. Commonly, elements is denoted by Aij, where I is number of rows and J is number of columns. Now take these three matrices. Here matrix Aij have the elements Aij equals 1, 2, 3, 4. Where the element 1 is done by first row and first column. So A11 is 1. 2 is done by first row and second column. So A12 is 2. 3 is done by second row and first column. So A21 is 3. 4 is done by first row and second column. So A22 is 4. As the same in Bij, A11 is 2, A12 is 4, A21 is 6, A22 is 8. And the Cij, A11 is 5, A12 is 10, A21 is 15, A22 is 20. Now still any doubt? See this very carefully. Now let us consider the following system of three linear equations in three unknown xyz. Solve its order, type and every element's position. First we write down the coefficients of xyz of the equations in a matrix form. Order is 3 cross 3. This is a square matrix. Position of the all elements are given here. Still we learn about two type of matrices as square matrix and rectangular matrix. But there has more different type of matrices. They are rectangular matrix, square matrix, diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, unit or identity matrix, zero or null matrix, row matrix, column matrix, triangular matrix, upper triangular matrix, lower triangular matrix, transpose of a matrix, symmetric matrix, skew symmetric matrix, singular matrix, orthogonal matrix, equality of matrices, rectangular matrix. We know the order format of a matrix is m cross n, where m is number of rows and n is number of columns. If m not is equal to n, is called a rectangular matrix. Here in this matrix, number of rows is 2 and number of column is 3. So m cross n is 2 cross 3. As m not is equal to n, it is a rectangular matrix. Square matrix. In a matrix where m and n is equal is called a square matrix. Here in this matrix have 3 rows and 3 columns. So m cross n is 3 cross 3. As m equals to n, it is a square matrix. Diagonal matrix. The matrix whose diagonal elements are non-zero but non-diagonal elements are zero is called a diagonal matrix. It is always a square matrix. Here in this example, the diagonal elements are non-zero, but non-diagonal elements are zero. Scalar matrix. In a diagonal matrix, when all diagonal elements are equal, is called a scalar matrix. Here in this matrix, all diagonal elements are same. So, it is the example of a scalar matrix. Unit matrix or identity matrix. In a diagonal matrix, which initial diagonal elements are unit or says to 1, is called unit or identity matrix. It is denoted by the letter capital I. Here in two examples, all diagonal elements are 1. Zero or null matrix. When every element of a matrix is 0, is called a null matrix. In these two matrices, all elements are 0. In another word, as there have no elements in these matrices, so these matrices are called null matrices. Row matrix. If a matrix has one row and any number of columns, is called a row matrix. In this matrix, have one row and three columns. So, it is an example of a row matrix. Column matrix. If a matrix has one column and any number of rows, is called a column matrix. In this matrix, have three rows and one column. So, it is an example of a column matrix. In a square matrix, if initial diagonal elements are 0, but other elements are non-zero, is called a triangular matrix. Here, diagonal elements are 0, but two triangular intersections, which are created by the diagonal, are not 0. Upper triangular matrix. In a square matrix, if initial diagonal elements are non-zero, but the lower triangular intersection is 0, is called a upper triangular matrix. In this example, the diagonal and upper triangular intersection is non-zero, but the lower triangular intersection is 0. Lower triangular matrix. In a square matrix, if initial diagonal elements are non-zero, but the upper triangular intersection is 0, is called a lower triangular matrix. In this example, the diagonal and lower triangular intersection is non-zero, but the upper triangular intersection is 0. Transpose of a matrix. Transpose of a matrix means to changing a matrix rows into its columns and columns into its rows. If the matrix is denoted by A, then its transpose denoted by A power T or A dash. Here order of A is m cross n, where order of A T is n cross m. See this example carefully. Here, which is matrix S column, that is A transpose row. And which is matrix S row, that is A transpose column. So, where order of A is 2 cross 3, there order of A transpose is 3 cross 2. Symmetric matrix. If the transpose of the matrix is equal to the main matrix, is called a symmetric matrix. Here in this example, A and A transpose is equal. So it is called the symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix. If the transpose of a matrix is equal to its negative of the main matrix, then it is called the skew symmetric matrix. Here in this example, A transpose is equal to negative of A matrix, and it is called the skew symmetric matrix. Singular matrix. A square matrix which name is P called a singular matrix when determinant of P is equal to 0. If determinant of P is not equal to 0, the matrix is called a non-singular or regular matrix. In this example, the determinant value of this matrix is 0. So it is a singular matrix. Orthogonal matrix. A square matrix which name is A called a orthogonal matrix when the multiplication of the main matrix A and its transpose is equal to I. In this example, matrix A is a orthogonal matrix because A and A transpose is equal to I. When two or more matrices are in same order and for all corresponding place have same element, then called two matrices are in equal form. Suppose A, B, C all matrix have the order 2 cross 2. So matrix B equals to matrix C because all elements are placed in the same corresponding place. Like these two matrices have A11 is 1, A12 is 4, A21 is 9, A22 is 16. If matrix A is come to equal to B and C, it also done by A equals to 1, B equals to 4, C equals to 9, and D equals to 16. Then we can to says matrix A, B and C are equal. Here I discussed all matrices with proper examples for just understand it. You may have any confusion about this lecture. Don't worry, it is just the introduction class. The next class will discuss this topic in details with proper applications. So attend the next classes for better knowledge. Dear viewers, thank you very much for watching this video. To make this video, I rely on my experience and knowledge. And in some cases, I got help some books and websites. If something is not understood in this video, please comment me from the comment section below. If you like this video, please click like button and share to others. To get more informative video on engineering subjects like this, please click the subscribe button and press the bell icon for latest updates. And it is totally free. So goodbye engineers, meet you soon.